things I'm trying to teach y'all. One, you can do whatever you want to do. And two, go hunt. Like, I need you to know how to hunt. Because if something happens to me, you got to go survive. So I'm not teaching you to live off my money.
This week, our show is brought to you by our partner in crime, Organifi. Organifi is an organic superfood supplement line that makes quality, trusted nutrition convenient and accessible. Their most popular product, Green Juice, can supercharge your life, restore that glow, and help you feel decades younger in just 30 seconds per day without having to worry about shopping for ingredients, mixing and blending them, and then cleaning up afterwards. All ingredients are USDA organic, vegan friendly, and made without GMO ingredients, gluten, or soy. Where else can you get superfoods like chlorella, moringa, spirulina, wheatgrass, ashwagandha, and turmeric, just to name a few? So make sure you guys check it out at www.Organifi.com/success. That's Organifi.com/success.
I wake up every single day. I am who I say I am. And I get what I get because I live in beast mode. Being gazelles, you're not average. You're not even good. You were born to be great.
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the Bayesian sensation, Mr. Carl Wesley Phillips.
What's going on, y'all? What it do?
I got Douglas. This is
a new year, bro. Okay. I mean, we ain't gonna get it. I feel like, let's just get rid of this whole room.
Yeah.
Build another room. Yeah. We just gotta do something
new
different,
energy.
Bro.
Douglas is sitting. This should be interesting. I don't know how. And then me and Maul in fighting distance.
Oh, that's good. Exactly. Hey, you don't know this, but me and E playing this. Dog.
Creed 3.
We playing it.
Creed 3.
Like, oh, let's go.
This feel like a setup.
Oh, let's go.
Creed 3. You can just, Maul, you can just reach next to him and just grab him.
I can just grab the little fella, the young fella.
The young whippersnapper.
Dr. King, what's going on? How you feeling?
Man, loving life, bro.
Yeah, man.
I'm in a room with my brothers.
Shout out to all the podcast listeners in podcast land. I know the rumors were flying. The podcast was over.
Wow.
The rumors were flying.
Make podcast real.
I didn't hear that.
Me and Maul had fell out. You know, me and E no
over
longer
cheese,
speaking.
Over the cakeity cake.
Yeah, you know, Carl decided to run off and become a real estate mogul on his own.
No doubt.
Now, I started all those rumors.
Okay.
Those were started by me. But we did take 2 weeks
two
off
weeks.
For the first time in, man, I don't, and ever. Yeah. We've been doing the podcast for, what, six
it's
years now?
Be six now. Yeah.
I come in don't feel
years?
Like we took off.
No.
We just took off from the podcast. We didn't take off. It wasn't a vacation.
No, and we're still talking about that. I unfortunately was still talking about the podcast.
Yeah. We did have a throwback episode. People hit me up like, "Yo, what's up with this?" I was like, "Oh, okay. If you like that, wait till next week.
You're gonna love next week. You're gonna love next week." But you know what I thought about? I was like, "Yo, that's crazy that we've done over 5 years worth of content." But we can't do reruns because everybody listened to it.
Yeah.
Like, that's crazy. Yeah. Like, you know, people who might come in year three,
they go all the way back.
Well, also, here's the other bad part is, for so long, we did it without video. It's like we don't even have a full six to choose from to post the throwback from years ago. It's like we only been doing video for I don't know how long. But it feels good not to be on
Zoom. Y'all can thank CJ for that because I'm like, I don't know why he put this much energy into. He could have just did season one.
I told you, man.
Episode two. He want to go. You know, he want to show video with the – Hey, we love y'all, bro.
Gotta give the people what they want. But we back. And he's back. I think we planned on only doing maybe a week. And then he was like, "Yo, I gotta go to Dubai."
Yeah.
I was like, "You joking." You know what I'm saying? You joking. But I guess, that's the true measure of how you did is when they invite you back.
Quick.
And I'm talking about it must have went well because they hit E. He said he's going back. I was like, I don't even want to know what that bag looked like. If you're going right back, I'm talking about right back.
That like one of Maul's sweet flip boys. One of Maul, when he tricked that joke out. The chandelier. Hanging from the chandelier.
So,
What
happened? Yeah. What happened?
Well, can I say this, though, before we go there? And it just might be me, Maul. But I've been, I remember going years without getting sick.
Yeah.
I mean, years, bro. Ever since COVID, I've been the throat ministry. Like, what is that? Yeah. The other day, you know, of course, you got to test it. That's what's so crazy.
Well, everything's COVID now.
Yeah, I'm just saying, though, here's the funny thing about it. And, you know, people debate or whatever. But at the end of the day, bro, you still got to test. That's why I'm like, what in the world? You got to test every single day. So anyway.
He said, you know I got test anxiety. He called me
before every test. He's like, yo, I got test, but I think I got COVID, dog. I'm like, yo, you ain't got COVID, dog.
I swear. Especially when C hit, you know, hit me like that. Yeah. I was like, C was straight to the. I'm like, you know, so anyway, bro, I promise you before COVID, I never had nothing. Or maybe I had something, but it wasn't nothing. So I don't even think, I didn't categorize it as something. Mm-hmm. But now, bro, it's like every week I feel like this my voice is like scratchy. I feel like that thing in the back. You know what I'm saying? I'm dousing you know, vitamin C, D, E.
No question.
You know, so I just thought about that today. I was like, yo, why does it seem like I'm getting, you know, never, like she said, I never had COVID, but I always feel like I wake up with it.
Somebody's like, watching me. I feel like it.
So, no. I'm telling you, and everybody do got COVID.
Yo,
that's the first sign. Bro. What they say? Oh, no, I just got a little allergies. Oh, no, man. Usually I just round this. It's the morning.
Bit of sinuses. Hey,
the one time I did think he had COVID, he used one of them reasons. That's how you know somebody got COVID.
Yeah.
He called me and was like, yeah, no, my throat, man. He's like, yeah, D left the windows open last night. I said, COVID.
I swear, bro. And maybe that's age too, Maul. I cannot take natural air. My daughter had the windows down on the way to school, bro. I feel like I'm about to die. I'm like, if you don't roll those windows up, she's like, the heat. I'm like, cut it off. I don't care. Yep. I just can't take cold, real air no more, bro.
Changed from you, because I remember when I first started hanging with E, I jump in the whip, and E got the windows down, and it's 35 degrees outside. Oh, yeah.
Well, I was just coming from Alabama. Yeah. I was just coming in from Bama, so I was used to, I was enjoying the fresh air. But, Michigan
but
switched that up.
Always, E ain't quite as bad as Marl and Camille House. Ooh. They just keep their heat on hell. But E pretty bad. Like, the bad part is, and Carl know, we used to have to share a hotel room.
Yeah.
And I told you, now you know me, I'm the pilot of the group, so I run right over to the temperature control, 69, 68. He'd be like, hey, C, I got to speak tomorrow.
Bro, I swear, Maul.
My throat, like when you got the air on, man.
Bro, it'd be killing me, Maul. All right. And I don't care what it is. You know, to me, I don't know who manufactures this stuff.
Yeah.
But when it's air. Like, if you put 70, it still don't feel like a normal 70 degrees.
That's a fact.
Cold air,
exactly.
70 degrees.
Yeah, that's a fact.
I'm like, bro, I just can't take it on my throat no more. I don't know what
70,
happened, man.
70 is like...
Bro, what we keep my throat.
What I'm saying is...
87.
Oh, quick.
No, Maul. If you listen to me, and maybe these are Chevys, I don't want to get in trouble with GMC, right? I don't care what it is. Cadillac, it don't matter. It's like, bro, either the heat work or the AC.
Yeah.
It's no thing where you can just get the room temperature, boy.
I gotta go 72.
It don't work, bro. It's either cold or you got to go hot. But it's not no, whatever. Anyway, I'm sorry. I just felt, you know what I'm saying? I just felt like sharing. I've been sick since COVID. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't had COVID yet.
Since COVID.
Let me just say this. I just feel like I gotta worry about my health.
Yeah, facts.
In a way that I never had to worry
y'all,
about it.
Because y'all ain't never had COVID. Once you get it and you beat it, it's kind of like, you know what?
No.
Hey, you feel relieved.
Until then, the boogeyman is still on you. You know what I'm saying? I'm not scared of the boogeyman no more. It is what it is.
It feels liberating.
Yeah.
Hey, we believe I had it, but I ain't got no real evidence because early.
No, Carl had it in 2019.
I had it early.
No, everybody said 2019.
I remember that.
Carl had it in 2019. And he ain't gotten it since because he had it.
I promise y'all. I got it since I had the scratchy throat when we went to San Diego. And I was scared. And I was like,
Carl got the real one.
That's
what
we
survived
the
it.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
We went to
and,
MOG.
And you know what?
Maul had 19. Maul had that regular COVID, that early batch. That
No, I'm talking about Carl
before
had
the vaccination.
It. Carl had it before 2020.
Yeah, no,
Carl had it in 2019.
Early 2019, end of 2019. Mm-hmm.
And I believe he would have died had he had it in 2020.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
If I knew what it was.
I'm telling y'all, I promise you, he was hurt.
Oh, yeah.
Carl lived because he didn't
know.
He just
didn't
He didn't know what it was.
It was the flu.
Oh, yeah, he was living in the basement.
That's a message in
itself.
Oh, bro, he was laid out for days. No, I was literally like a week. I was laid out, bro.
If somebody would have told you you had COVID, your heart would have died.
He would have died. I'm just saying because he would have been like, I got to go to the hospital.
I got COVID.
He just thugged it out. Yeah, in the basement.
That's a fact.
He just thugged out in the basement.
I do remember
he been,
that.
Carl would have been one of the first ones on the ventilator. He would have, for real, because he would have gone to the doctor's office. They would have told him that he couldn't breathe. He was out. Yeah. He was like, he couldn't move, bro. Wow. They would have to give him something for that.
Yeah. Wow.
But he didn't know, so he just stayed at the crib. Thugged it out. And then 2020 was like, 2019, he was like, he was like, did I have that?
You did.
Yeah, he had it. Well, didn't your family, somebody in the family, one of the kids sick? Or just you?
No, just me. Oh, okay. Literally, it was just me that
one
time.
And you quarantined.
Oh, I did.
He quarantined. Didn't he know what quarantine was?
Before quarantine, he needed to quarantine.
I remember, because then we did a podcast, and you was in the basement. Yeah, you didn't come out the basement for a minute.
I was hurting. Hurting.
Yeah,
so.
I think he had that. Bro, there's no other explanation for it.
They just be sending you food down the stairs like Sloth on Goonies. You know what I'm saying? You just be chained up.
I know our sponsor might get rid of us, but
don't worry about it.
Yeah. Organifi.
Don't worry about it.
But Ma, I truly believe, I have no empirical evidence, but I truly believe somebody died that got it because they felt like, I got it.
Oh, no, for sure.
That's the number one killer. They said that's the number one killer.
Oh, he said that?
Yeah.
Okay, Sean said that.
It's obesity first, then worrying about COVID.
No, I'm telling you, because Carl had something. He wasn't worried about it, though. He wasn't even worried. Hey. Carl was chilling.
I feel slightly attacked right now.
No, the power of suggestion, because I remember Marl had it, and Marl was straight. Like, you know, he had just left my career.
Yeah.
So I thought I had it.
Oh, yeah.
And I ain't have it, so I was calling him, like, you straight? He was like, yeah, I was straight till Carla called me. Talking about, you need a breathing machine. I'm about to send you a ventilator.
You hey, bro, Carla would call my phone.
I was straight. I start feeling my throat close up.
She would call my phone asking me, do I need a breathing machine?
Yeah, your heart rate changed.
And then she was like, yeah, you're not supposed to be breathing good.
I
cut my phone off because even Josh would call and be like, you know, so Josh, you know, we got Josh is on this side, C on this side.
Right.
C would call like, hey, you good? What
get
you doing?
Your butt up.
Yeah. Like, you work out. See, hit you like, you work out today? No, you got COVID. You work out today? He hit you on that. Hey, like, hey, what you doing, dog? What you doing?
What Josh hit you on?
Oh, Josh is like, oh, Josh sent flowers to the
house. Oh, wow.
What funeral home you want me to send the flowers to?
Hey, Josh sent you a whole care package.
Wow.
I'm talking about, I ain't mad at that, though.
Right, no question.
Wow. I'm talking about a blanket.
No, let me tell you something.
Medicine,
a little baby Bible.
And that's what I meant by, if we would have known COVID, there's no way we would have let Carl just be in the basement.
Oh, no,
just chilling
COVID,
like that.
Coming back from Mexico.
Yeah.
Remember?
Oh, yeah, y'all was blew out.
Bro,
oh,
it was blew out. Mexico.
I remember that too.
Oh, we was messed up.
Yeah. It was just the stomach. It was the stomach COVID. No, a train was on the flight with it. God spared me to get home when I caught it.
Oh, okay.
But it was one of them where you just live in the bathroom. I'm talking about you.
But it wasn't COVID though.
I don't know what it was. I don't know.
Okay.
Wasn't no name for it.
Spanish-speaking COVID.
But that was the 2019.
Into
2019, into going 2020. Into 2020. Just a couple months before COVID. And I'm talking about out of there. Now, the only good thing is I did lose about 8-9 pounds in a day. You know what I'm saying?
Lee Lamb had. So we call Lee.
That jumpstart e-weight loss journey a few years ago.
It wasn't COVID, though.
It was
remember
flu.
You had that flu?
Little Davion. Little Davion gave me the stomach flu.
Oh, bro, he came back. Bruh. I'm talking about lean and mean.
3 days.
If you watch the NC State, it was like,
bruh,
when he got home from the one-pack, one-go.
Oh, bro.
He got home from the one-pack, one-go, caught the flu.
I'm talking about gold. And little man, I knew he gave it to me because I spent the night and he had it.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to just coach him out of it.
Yeah.
As soon as he went to the crib and got better, I got it. Bro, I'm talking about, like, 50, remember 50 Cent played in that role and 50 lost all that weight? Bro, I was on the 50 Cent boy. Bro, it was unbelievable, bro. It hurt, but it was so worth it.
Let me tell you something. He came out there with a new diet regimen. Yeah. He was running all the stuff. Yeah. And I was like, dang.
Yeah. All it take ball is one good sickness. It.
Yeah, we,
yeah,
we,
bro.
We,
yeah, hey, good, so, yeah, my bad, good Carl.
Now? No, you got to ask Lee.
So Lee called us.
Because Lee had that bee sting for a minute.
And you know what was crazy? He ended up getting COVID after the bee sting. Mm-hmm. So he had lost a lot of weight. And then maybe was going back, maybe, but he had lost a lot of weight, and he ended up catching it. I promise you, Marlon, everything I love, we saw him on the – Lee said it. Lee said he was straight the day of. Mm-hmm. Then somebody had told him, you got it. He said, next thing you know, he was in the hospital. So when he was in the hospital, you know, I call, finally got through. I call. We FaceTime him. I'm in Cali, so L was at the crib. So I saw Lee, and Lee had fully gotten to it. He had gotten it. So whoever had told him, he was fully into it. You could see him in the hospital. The nurse was right there. He had that look. L looked at that Negro. L said, get up off the bed. Get up, Lee. Get up. Get up. I'm not lying. Yeah. L was like, no, Lee, don't go that way, bro. Yeah, like, wow. Don't go. Get up. Don't get out that bed. Get out that hospital. Mm-hmm. And Lee was like, no, for real. I needed to hear. Yeah. I needed to hear that because he was like, life. Yo, I was, you know, they told me I had the pneumonia of the heart.
Yep.
It's like some lungs or something. He had pneumonia in his lungs. He said he had fluids in his lung, had pneumonia, you know, and it hit quick. He don't know why it hit quick. And L was like, no, I'm not playing. L was like, yo, you looking like you starting to, you know, believe the report of the, and you in the environment. Mm-hmm. You in that joker. They said you got this. You're breathing this, whatever. He had the little boy was shooting, and L was like, man, right, bro, for real, whatever. And I was like, you know what, L? I was like, I got to really repent. I was like, because I remember when COVID first hit, bro, I was praying to no end. Hmm. After about 2 years, I was like, oh, we lost. I just got settled. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't going to lie. Like, I ain't necessarily scared of it, but I was like not praying that hard no more. And my boy had got hit, and I was just like, oh, you're going to be all right, but you're going to be in there for a minute. L was like, get your butt up out of there, you know, sit up. Like you see what's saying, exercise, do your thing. So, yeah, man, we got to pray just to make it today.
Yeah.
But that brain's something terrible, though, man. It's something different.
Yeah, no, it is.
It's like, man.
Nah. Yeah, it'll make you think some things. You know what I'm saying? You got to stay on that positive side, man. So shout out to everybody there, you know, dealing with COVID, lost loved ones.
Yeah, everybody
ones,
lost a loved one. You're dealing with it. Yeah everybody. Love, it's real, man.
Yeah, it ain't no joke.
Yeah, it's
for
real,
sure.
Bro.
You
it's
know,
serious.
That's why, you know, you try to stay ready as much as possible. Yeah. And it ain't no guarantee.
Yeah.
It just means stay ready. Maul, what you been up to, man? Yeah, what'd you do with the 2-week break? As they like to call it.
Bro, no such thing as a 2-week break over here, bro.
From the podcast. Okay, we know Superman. Here we go.
I'm just saying, bro. Hey.
Breaking news. Maul is still.
Hey, what's so funny? He don't push them buttons when I be showing him them checks, though.
Oh, no question.
But when I show him them checks, though, he don't be pushing. He don't be pushing them buttons,
push the buttons
on what I'm on. So, no,
you
know, just.
Get a new button to push when Maul show you the check, see?
Why I got to get one? Must be the money.
Yeah. Get that Dion boy.
Just working, man. Just working, bro. Just, you know, new developments taking place. A lot of developments taking place.
Mm-hmm.
And, that's it, man. Just you know, family, you know, staying in the gym twice a day. You know what I'm saying?
Not the two of those.
Getting them arms right.
Not the two of them. Breaking
news. Getting them arms right.
Yeah, get them arms right, bro. Come on. Keep that consistency.
All right. Come on, man. How was Dubai? Tell us. I mean, how did it compare? I feel like we just had this pod.
It was definitely not that. Like, definitely not.
Uh-huh.
Oh, no. When Marlon was with us. Now, I will say this, though, Maul.
Oh, by the way, I heard y'all had like a little Dubai group text.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, okay. I was like, they still be texting stuff. So I'm like, wow. I didn't get added. I never got added back, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, Maul was like,
because you wouldn't understand.
Hey. You know, like, we were sitting there. Maul was like, ha-ha-ha, y'all stupid. He was on the group. I was like, what you doing? He was just getting weak. Like, no, nothing. I was like,
this don't concern
me. I was like, what you keep laughing for? He was like, it's just a little Dubai group text. I was like, oh, no,
it's a little something.
My wife got deleted off of that.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
I think they might have had an A5 hamburger.
Ooh.
What Camille had when she told you
at
the executive lounge, bro, I had it. Bruh. You don't need teeth. for the bird. You feel me? I just want to encourage anybody
that
out there.
Definitely A5.
You,
no
you, bro, yeah, you don't need no teeth, bro. Bruh. That's definitely. Maul. Bruh. Bruh, I ain't never had nothing like it, Maul. I said, man, praise God for your wife. I don't even know what made Camille think that she could order that at 8 o'clock in the morning.
8 o'clock in
I'm
the morning.
I'm still thinking about, like, how does she... Now, we was on the...
Camille don't do breakfast, though.
So she don't, okay. Yeah, she oh, okay. So yeah, that's what it is.
She don't eat eggs.
Yeah.
Bro, we went in exact line, 8 o'clock. Now, it's whatever time because our bodies are whatever.
Right. Yeah, of course.
But she went in and did it. So as soon as I went in, my man was like, what you want? He said, eggs? I said, I told him what I said. He said, breakfast? I said, bro, I just told you.
A breakfast burger.
Bro, burger. Nah, I ain't going to lie, Maul. I did the breakfast burger. Told him to hold everything else, but give me the eggs.
So yeah, the eggs. Yeah.
So I did do the burger by itself halfway.
Yeah.
And then had to go ahead and egg it up a little bit. I ain't going to lie. Bro, Didi got a vegetarian burger. They had a veggie burger at 7 o'clock in the morning. Didi said the best veggie she ever had in her life. So let me say this, though. We didn't do none of the stuff that we did with y'all. All we did was Hakkasan's, you know, we did the basement, whatever.
Yeah.
And, you know, we enjoyed that, walked up and down, but we was in the hotel, we was like in the room, bruh. We went to the Dubai Mall twice. Not gonna lie, first time we went, we did go get the chicken split in half.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, yeah. That definitely got that. But then we went to the Cheesecake Factory. Listen to me, bruh. Let me be careful. All these haters be like, I can't believe you said that. Let me just say this to you. I was talking to somebody from South Africa, Rocky, who's in Dubai now. He explained it to me, Maul. He said, and you have to tell me, Maul, because I don't know the difference. Like, so when you're putting granite or marble in, have you noticed like a company that you like, this is the best company or this is the best? Okay, so what company is that, would you say? What kind of, is it granite? Is it marble? What's the best of the...
Like, well, what's the best stone?
Yeah, what's the best stone?
I'm going to say, because the company, they put them all
in. Yeah, but what's the best stone?
I would say quartz.
Quartz.
So, whatever. So he explained to me, Dubai is quartz, mm-hmm. but the best quartz are the quartz.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Tier three.
So, my man was like, so whatever it is, they get the best of that best.
Yeah.
That's Dubai. And I was like, yo, got it. Makes sense, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yo, it makes sense. So, I'm like, that's why they don't want to get a tip. You know what I'm saying? Because cats is like, yo, we ain't, bruh, I'm going to show you a picture. Please put this picture up, Carl. I call myself trying to be a little structured, a little organized. I got one little space where I'm putting all my dirty clothes. So we're going to dirty clothes it out, put them in the bag, and then stuff them in my bag when I leave. Maul, I come in one day, bruh. This is a man who doing my room. I come in one day, Maul, he got the, I don't even know what to call it, Maul, but you know when you get like fancy shoes or fancy clothes? Like, let's say you go to Louis and you buy Louis and they give you that bag that you put everything in. Maul, he had two of those on the ground and literally fold all my stuff up and had it sitting there, Maul. Lo, he got my dirty clothes. Maul, he had a section for my socks where he folded them up, section for my underwear. I guess he could tell the hip-hop preacher sweater must have been sweet, so he separated that and put it that by itself. Then he had all my shorts, all my T-shirts. I just was like, bruh, it's a different mindset. Yeah. Meanwhile, I'm back at home, and watch your mouth,
careful
now. Watch your mouth.
Careful,
let me just say this. Meanwhile, I'll come back to the... I ain't even back at the crib.
Back and at the ranch.
Let me just say this, Maul. There are people trying to pay their rent, not necessarily... operate at the highest level. Mm-hmm. I think that's the easiest way to say it. And what I notice about Dubai is that they care first about the work and the quality of their work.
Absolutely.
They not on that, I want a tip. They not even working for tips. Mm-hmm. They on something different, bruh. Bruh, so much so that it was a fight, Maul, at the hotel. Emirates came and scooped me, but Atlantis was like, oh, no, we good. We took him already. Yeah, we good. We got him. They called me at 5:30, like, you ready to go to the airport? I'm like, yeah, but Emirates told me they're coming at 6. They was like, don't worry about it. We got a Mercedes-Benz car for you. Don't worry about it. Waiting for you.
Meanwhile, I'm in Atlanta catching COVID from an Uber driver.
You know what I'm saying? Catching COVID. Maul, the Cheesecake Factory was the best Cheesecake Factory I ever had. Yeah. Bro, they don't even, Cheesecake ain't even Dubai. Cheesecake is, what, Chicago, whatever. The Cheesecake Factory, it was the best pasta I ever had. It was the best cheese. And Didi and I was like, we're not going to do American food while we here. But I was just like, D, we in the mall. We already did the Lebanese boy. Let's, you know, Mediterranean. Let's go.
You wanted a sandwich.
I didn't even get it. I just got the pasta. Didi got the veggie sandwich. Didi said, Bruh, so I'm through. But let me just say this. It's the best of the best. Yep. And I came back and said, E, you got to make a commitment to yourself. You got to start doing the best of the best. Hmm. And by that, I mean, I ain't going to lie. It's some sermons, bruh, where I sit down, go in my Bible, go in my, you know, strong
concordance,
boy, you know, for real, go Greek, Hebrew, you know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be deep, but just get some research, whatever, speak. Sometimes, more, I just be in the spirit, and I just, yeah. And God was like, yo, do me a favor. What's your best? Give me your best every time, Eric. Mm. Because if you do your best every time, you know the results going to be different. Mm. Like, you already know when Kobe put up 80, they probably going to win. Mm. I'm not trying to be funny. Kobe put up 80. The chances of some young lady put up 50 for Michigan State, I'm sure we win it. Some young girl put up 61. I'm sure when you put up 61, the chances of you winning. And God was just like, yo, there's, like, I know, son, you beast mode. But there are times when you just beast mode. Mm. Yep. You're not high level beast mode. And you know your beast mode is beast mode because you in the room with people who may not be beast. But you know you got another level. In 2022, just give me that level. And so, bruh, Emirates.
Well, you said something though right there.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Trying your hardest is not your best.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? No, I don't want people to get that confused. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, oh, I tried hard. Like, I, you know, I really was.
Oh, no question.
So you just give us an example, though. You're saying you was in beast mode, but it wasn't your best.
Bruh, I went to Dubai, and I was like, yo, E, you know what you could, like, and it's weird, y'all. It's weird because it's like, people usually get a best when they competing, like they competitive. And you got another human across from you. And you like, C doing what? Mm-hmm. I'm C score 40, I'm about to get 50. But it comes a point when you get to a point of beast mode where you like MJ, I guess basketball at some point, like I used to always wonder, like, he could have got 8. What was he thinking? Bro, you know what it take when you better than everybody on the court and just like, it ain't fun no more. Mm-hmm. When you Kobe and you
that's how I feel on the podcast.
Yeah, that's that feeling. Like,
it's just, that's how I feel in life. That's how I feel in life.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just like,
that's how I feel in life, young
why am I doing this?
And I'm just saying, like, that's real, though.
That is.
But for a lot of us, when we get to that point, we go complacent.
Yeah.
Mm. Because it's like, yo, I'm whatever. And God was like, yo, you know you could go into a room. I'm not playing, Ma. Dubai was 8,000 people in the room. I'm already knowing when I go in that room that 90% of those people have not experienced what I've experienced. They haven't traveled the world. They're not where I am economically. Mm-hmm. Bruh, anything I say at this point gonna be beast mode. Let's just be real. You haven't experienced what I've experienced. You ain't been married like I've been married, kids. You haven't gone through what I've gone through, life, just life. Bruh, I'm gonna get up on the mic and then you got the other dudes that's coming before me. They not even speakers. Like, they're teachers. They coming in here to tell you the comp program. They telling you the product. They're not even speakers. Like, it ain't fair. I got on stage, bro. They did the whole choo, 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 choo. There's like, E, bring your hand out. And when you do like this, stand back. Because we going choo, choo, choo to music. Doesn't nobody else get that presentation. The fact that I got the choo, choo, choo. I'm already sweeping everybody in the room.
Before
I even spoke. But God said to me, he was like, yo, I want you to think about that message. I don't care if you was in church. Where you just felt the synergy, the language. Bro, Ma, I did my thing and sat down and God was like, bro, 80% of the people in this room was from Colombia and they spoke Spanish. You did a little bit, but you should have been able to do the whole message. Matter of fact, there was a dude who was from there. He was like, they kept screaming, like, speak Spanish. He's like, I can't. He's from, I don't know where he was from, but he was like one of their leaders. He's like, I can't, but the company is, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can't do that. But he was like, I'll do the Spanglish on y'all. I'll give you a little bit of this, a little bit. I got to keep it English. But for me, I was like saying a couple things. And I was like, yo, E, bro, you should have, like, God been told you was going to be doing this. Mm-hmm. But because you didn't see you was going to be doing this, and quite frankly with you, Ma, because you make as much money as you make without speaking another language, you straight. Yep. You cool. Because you don't even know you're going to be doing this. Mm-hmm.
With inflation hitting a 39-year high, you don't need a PhD in economics to know that the $100,000 in your bank account could turn to $94,000 real soon. So what can you do? Experts suggest investing in alternative assets that historically thrive in high inflation environments. In fact, there's one unexpected alternative asset that appreciates by 23% annually on average when inflation is above 3% like it is right now, which is better than many of the popular investment strategies, even better than gold. And it has almost no correlation to public equities. Would you believe me if I told you that this alternative asset was contemporary art? Although it's surprising, using art to safeguard wealth isn't a new idea. The ultra wealthy have been doing it for centuries, and now you can too with Masterworks.io. It's the new tech platform valued at over $1 billion. You heard me correctly, $1 billion. That lets you invest in paintings by Warhol, Picasso, and Banksy like stocks. You don't need hundreds of millions to add art to your portfolio anymore. You just need a solid internet connection to get started. Demand from Masterworks is as high as ever. But because you listen to the Secrets to Success podcast, you can get priority access to their offerings by going to masterworks.art/success. Again, that's masterworks.art/success. See important disclosures at masterworks.io/disclaimer.
You feel me? And one young lady, we had a like I was doing 15 people and I was one-on-one with her. And she was like, yo, I ain't gonna lie to you. She's like, yo, your accent. She's like, yo, you sound like, who you studying with? Cause you sound like, and I was just like, I'm not even trying. So when she finished saying that, Maul, I was studying and doing all kinds of stuff. I was like, why don't you just always wake up and go beast mode? And so see, it was just like, yo, you gotta stop competing against other people because one of the challenges, and I don't mean it like that. For those of you who are listening, like I don't mean I'm waking up. What is Maul doing? What's he? I'm not on that. But I do mean that there are levels to other motivational speakers, that whatever, Instagram, whatever. It's like, okay, E, go for it. But it's like, E, you got more in the tank, and God requires more from you than he may require from somebody else. Like, yo, you know what it takes to go to that next level. So for me, see, it's studying more. For me, it's, you know, I used to have this thing where I talked to the clients before I spoke. And I still do it in paper, and in theory I do it. I'm not going to lie to you, I do. But I already know what's going on in corporate America. So it's like, I already know what's going on. So I'm going to come in here and blow y'all mind because I know more about corporate than y'all know about corporate because I've been doing it for 30 years. And God's like, you do and you can and you gonna excite them. But you still could have talked to the CEO a little bit more. It's kind of like, Maul, I look at these basketball players. I'm like, why they be doing the same reps every single time? Like, why they just keep shooting the ball the same way? Like, why does they keep practicing like this? And it's like muscle memory. I get it. And so there are things that I know about myself that I could do more, that I could do regularly, and I'm not doing it. And when I came back from Dubai, it was like, the way you love the Emirates experience, you got to do that. You know, I believe, Maul, the Emirates lounge is better than the Emirates plane. Mm. They competing against each other. Mm. My man was like, you and your wife didn't eat at all. I was like, for what? Why would we eat this food when we got the lounge? Mm. This garbage. Mm-hmm. Bruh, it's garbage. Nah, y'all got to hear what I'm saying. It will blow Delta out the sky. It will blow whatever the mother airlines out.
I'm saying, that ain't saying much with Delta right now.
Delta was good. You know what I'm saying? American with the hot cookie.
There you go.
I'm just being real, Maul.
The hot cookie with the little chocolate. Oh,
Emirates food will blow. Bro, I was in the shower. I took a shower on the plane, bro. I saw you. You saw how they give you the time. I sent it.
Wait.
Oh, here we go, Ma. Here we go, Ma.
He sends nudies to Ma.
So,
in the shower from the Emirates.
But I want y'all to hear what I'm saying.
He was Emirates. Like, I saw.
Are you sure you want to be in that group chat?
Yeah, I'm straight on that group chat. That had turned into something else.
Hey, does he sound like C getting a little jealous right now?
No, that ain't jealous, bro. That's disgusting.
Maul know what he's up. But Maul, I said to myself.
That was on the group chat.
I sent it to everybody.
Maul know what he saw.
He said
Maul know what he saw.
I sent it to Camille too.
No, I sent it to Carl. Carl know what he saw.
I get it.
Jamal got it. Maybe it was just on the
group chat, bro.
Maybe it was.
Now I see why we're not invited, Carl.
I sent it to Jeremy.
You swingers.
But I'm tripping though because Emirates is competing with Emirates.
Yeah.
Mm. You understand what I'm saying?
Emirates ground and Emirates air.
They compete. Yeah. So here's what Didi said. Diddy said, we will no longer fly to Dubai, land, and go to the hotel. We're going to go to the executive lounge first. Mm.
And chill out.
And eat. She said, we're going to go to the executive lounge and eat.
Oh, wow.
So I told my man, and I was like, yo, hey, can I ask you a quick question? I said, what's your hours? He said, what you mean by that? I was like, your operating hours. He said, we 24/7. I said, what? He said, we don't close. You can eat like this and get this. And so I just like, the dude, everybody was hurt on the Emirates because they like, you spent all that money and you didn't eat. I was like, I did. Mm-hmm. But your executive lounge got y'all, the executive lounge covered y'all.
Yep.
So I didn't want to eat this that y'all, I didn't want to eat this. He's like, get something, get a sandwich, get something. I was like, all right, give me a steak, whatever, bro. It was whatever. So I'm just saying, bro, God said, when you go back, find a way, whoever it is or whatever it is, because you have way more in you. But if you are, as TJ used to tell me, the difference between Central Michigan, right? He played for Central. He's like, some of the dudes that play for Central, and you seen Antonio Brown, JJ Watts, them dudes come from Central.
Mm-hmm.
TJ was like, it's not that they don't have any five-star recruits, but he was like, the reality is, that some of the players that starting may or may not be, but none of the second string is.
Mm-hmm.
He said none of them. Mm-hmm. He said the difference between Alabama mm-hmm. is the first string, second string, third string. They all five-star recruits.
Mm-hmm.
He said, so what happens is we going through Michigan's drills. We going through the drills. We know every play. TJ was like, I know every play they going to do. But when we play against Michigan, our second string that ran the play, I tackled my man. But when I played Michigan, my man, when I got, teacher said, I'm not lying. Most of us, when we got to the spot, I don't know about him, but he said, most of us, when they got to the spot, my man wasn't there. Because you were practicing against the second string speed.
Yeah.
So he said, Alabama's so good because, and I watched Cincinnati play, was it Bama? They said Cincinnati wasn't used to that speed and they wasn't used to that size. Because everybody they played, they won against, they was 12-0, whatever they were against, but they didn't play that caliber. And God says, when you go back, find, practice with Jordan. Practice with Kobe.
Come on.
Practice with, so that when you play, you can't nobody hold you because.
You're used to that speed.
Yeah,
I mean, you take the, you know, the opposite end of the spectrum and you look at an Alabama and imagine you come in as a freshman.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so you wonder why they good year in and year out.
Yeah.
Because look who you going against.
Yeah.
Look who you modeling your routes after.
Yep.
Look who speed you got to match. Look who, like, you got to tackle. Look who, you know what I'm saying? You already going. So then if you look in the league, who got the most players in the league?
Bama.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Bama, Georgia, Ohio State, the teams that, it's like, yo, it's, but here's the thing. You develop a system. Again, that just churns out best and the brightest. That must be what's happening at Chick-fil-A. I'm just saying, like, they came in under a system of, like, beasts. And so you have no choice. Because guess what? If you're sorry, you out of here.
So, you're not even comfortable.
You see what I'm saying? You can't even.
You're not comfortable.
You got to transfer.
So you want to leave.
Bro.
You got to transfer, bro. You know, can't sit in here. You can't sit here.
I heard my wife say, she said, and I know Chris told her when he was alive, rest in peace, Chris. But it clicked for Didi, and Didi was like, yo, I'm a pilot, but in a lot of situations, I'm not with pilots, and I find myself backing up so that they could feel comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, I'm not doing that no more. And she said, because what happens is when I get comfortable, I'm no longer executing.
Mm.
Like, because now I'm on your level, which is not executing, which is not getting nothing done. You know what I'm saying? But I'm making you feel comfortable because I don't want you to be uncomfortable, but then I have to sacrifice executing at a high level.
Yeah.
And so when she was in Dubai, she's like, yo, that's how the church should look. But when I'm on these calls, we fighting over, she's like, yo, I'm not doing that no more. When I come back, if I know something's supposed to be done, we're going to go get it done because we worship and we magnify the Lord. This don't got nothing to do with us. So if I could be in Dubai and the hotel look like this, there's no reason that the church shouldn't look like that. Yeah. Or anything else we touch. And the boxes, the 120 stuff's coming out. She's like, yo, we have the same access that Nike got, yep. the same access that Under Armour got. We got the same access. So we not doing nothing inferior no more. And if it causes you to feel uncomfortable or it makes you feel like I'm trying to, she like, I'm good on that because I tried to do it your way. Mm-hmm. But people piss when they getting a product. I don't mind spending $100.
Bro, feel and look like $100.
Bro, right. Everywhere we go, Louis is in Dubai. Louis was packed in Dubai. Right. In Dubai was packed, bro. God. My man had a shirt. I tried to get the shirt. I come to America, got a concierge. She like, yo, that shirt gone. See, I'm like, yo, how's Louis doing that? How's Louis selling stuff that's like exclusive? How, if everybody buying that, why you only make four? You made 40 of them. Why, how'd you do that? How's that purse? I'm confused. I'm like, that purse is fire. How y'all keep coming out with new, but that one is discontinued? How do you have the heart? Who are you that if you got something fire, you don't just blow that joker out everybody. And let 1,000 people buy? Like, how is that possible? But something in their mind that they, like you said, they just could keep producing the best that they like, yo, when you sell it, like if you buy it from us and you sell it 3 years later, bro, I bought a jacket for $7,000. I bought a Louis jacket. I ain't touched it. I left it there. I was like, Nene, I don't want to wear it. I don't know if I want to wear that. She said, don't make a difference if you want to or not. Give it 3-4 years. You can sell it and get double for it. I said, why you say that? Because Louis don't got it no more, but people still want that jacket. 100%. And so I'm like, why are we selling 1,000 of ours, Ma? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, you know the crazy thing? And me and Cam were talking about this the other day. Louis packed. Chanel packed. Guess who else packed? Marshalls.
Yeah. Marshall's packed.
No, I'm being for real. You ever been to Marshall's?
Diddy always in Marshall's.
Bruh.
Diddy stay in Marshall's.
It's like a line like Cedar Point.
Diddy stay in Marshall's.
And Marshall's keep like 7,000 cashiers going.
Mm-hmm.
And I told Kansas, I was like, yo, it's crazy. It's kind of like, if you think about it, who's stuck in the middle? Ain't nobody yet. No disrespect to Macy's and stuff like that, but Macy's ain't packed like that no more. And I'm talking about like, yo, so, and I was thinking, I'm like, dang, so it's like, either you just acknowledge that you're comfortable at the bottom and just start living your life there. Like, Marshall's like, bruh, $14.99. Oh, matter of fact, oh, that got a little the button falling off. Right, give me $5.
Give me $5.
I'm saying. But that's the game that they playing, and they comfortable playing that. Yeah. But I feel like most humans get stuck in that world of trying to reach for Louis, feeling like they too good for Marshall's.
Yeah.
And then you get stuck in that middle ground of Macy's where it's like, ain't nobody really fooling with you like that. And it's crazy because, man, as humans, what you're talking about, the best of the best, that's what we strive for. Like, we're taught to strive for that level, like, for real. And I'm trying to use this example. And, again, you get people who, again, they comfortable with their life. You know what I'm saying? They might live at Marshall's, and they like, bro, I'm good. I'm genuinely good with the Marshall's experience. But, man, the most frustrating thing in the world, you said it, E, is not necessarily being broke and comfortable with it, is having something or thinking you should have something and not being able to attain that level.
But you got to be careful. Most people think Marshall's is Louis. Most people have never been exposed to that level. They don't even know Louis even exists, dog.
They know it exists, but they don't even let their mind go
there. Let's go blue collar. Yeah. Let's go to the blue collar.
Well, Diddy go to both.
You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
In the blue collar world, dog, like Marshall's is like, you know, that's the top.
Yeah, Macy's.
It's a Macy's.
I don't think they think Marshall's.
No, Macy's. Excuse me. So, like, Macy's.
Yeah, I would say, you know, Spiegel's. You know what I'm saying?
He will bring up some old Detroit.
No, I'm just saying. It's my age.
I was about to ask, what is it?
I thought I was the only one.
Because Marshall's, because Macy's ain't really.
Woolworth.
No. And I say that because Macy's is that. But it was before, it was Marshall Fields.
Yeah,
it was BSP. It was big time.
Hudson's.
Oh, wow. Hudson's was Marshall Fields of Chicago. Hudson's was that. Hudson's, so that's different. That's what they grew up on. Middle class people grew up on that. Not necessarily Marshall's or Macy's. Macy's is a downgrade from Marshall Fields or from BSP.
Macy's is a downgrade from Marshall
Fields? Yeah, Marshall Fields was high
for
level.
Real?
Yes.
Back in the day,
level.
Marshall
Back
Fields
in the day.
Was,
it was high
Marshall
level,
Fields?
Bro. Yeah, it was like, it was like
Hudson's.
No, what would you say? That story you say, now Neiman Marcus. Or,
oh, for real?
Yeah,
okay,
it was like
maybe
that.
I didn't know about I'm thinking about Marshall still.
Yeah,
that must have been Marshall's big cousin.
Right. I just want to set the record straight. So when Maul was saying,
Marshall Fultz.
Yeah, so if you, right. So I'm just saying, so to your point, you were working class, but you was B. Spiegel's Marshall Fields. That was the Louis, whatever. It wasn't, but it was still more regal. Mm-hmm. You feel me? It still had some high-end, middle class, but some high-end stuff. You know, but to your point, nobody ever looked at the Prada, the Louis, the Gucci. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna be real, I'm gonna leave that alone, but I think Gucci kind of under a little bit.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, I wouldn't know. Yeah.
Under Louis, you saying?
Yeah, I've been around these guys now lately. Yeah. And then let me say this, bruh. This dude had on a, I ain't gonna say names because I don't know if he want me to say it, but the group I was just with, he had on a pair of shoes and I saw him, was like, bro, them fire. He was like, what size you wear? Next level, Ma. Next level.
You got these in the six and a half.
Next level.
You got these in Geppetto.
Don't even go there. You got to learn when you mature that you just, keep going, bro. You keep going. So he was like, which one you want? I'm like, wow. Because the other dude had the blue ones.
Yeah.
You want that one or that one? So I told him 10 and a half. He's like, he don't know. Because he from Dubai. So he didn't know what that was. So he called a store. Next thing I know, they come into my hotel room with the shoes.
No.
Bro, Diddy looked them up today. Them jokers $1,000. Bro, my man was like, what size you wear? He said, you want the blue ones? Because they got the blue ones and these. And I was like, nah, bro, I ain't on that. Yeah. Just give me the ones you got on. Because I could, with the khakis, I could. Bro, I just looked at them today. $800. Bro, $1,000. I'm looking at the shirt, the pants, Ma. The pants that he had, $850. So I'm just saying, like, we weren't exposed to that level. Mm-hmm. You feel me? We were exposed to, you know, what was my father wearing?
Docs.
Was it Johnson and Murphy's? How do you say it? Murphy's.
That's it.
Johnson Murphy's. Those was like $300, $350. And he wore a 18. So I know it was a little bit more because his feet were so big. But just in general, those jokers was like two something. So you looked at shoes like two, whatever. And so to your point, we didn't know the next level. You feel me? We never saw it. We didn't get out of our community to see that. So
I feel like if you are at that level and you cool, then fine.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? But
Maul always says, you cool with that because that's what you exposed to.
That's all you know.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So we go to the Marshall Fields,
right,
and then we start looking at the best in Marshall Fields.
Right.
We wouldn't even attempt to go to Louis, Gucci, right, Prada, right. I don't even know where those stores
were. I don't even know where they were, though. They weren't even in there back in the day.
They didn't even exist.
They was in Paris or something.
No. Maybe they exist.
They weren't
in your mall. I never got a Louis magazine sent to my house when I was a kid.
Yeah.
But now, I get them jokers every single.
That's because you buy Louis Vuitton. You're on the mail.
That's my point.
No, I'm just saying. And maybe they were at another store that we weren't going to. Like, I don't know. Like, because we weren't going to Somerset Mall when I was a kid. We were going to Northland, Fairlane. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know that, you know, we never went to repair and check cash. No question.
I'm processing, and we talked about this on a grounds crew call, but we literally broke it down into people go after three categories, right? KTW. The first category the average person goes after is just what you know you can get. And I was thinking, literally this morning, I was writing and thinking about that. And I was like, yo, that makes sense because if I go after, I can get this water bottle.
Right.
And I get that. Bro, I feel good. Like, that's automatically a good feeling. Like, yo, I set that goal. I got it.
Yep.
Right? Category one. Category two, man, I think I can get two of these. So I'm going to push myself a little beyond that. But I wrote this morning. I'll pull it up just so you can. Wrote this morning. Like, yo, I don't think you get to your authentic self until you hit the third one, which is, what do you want?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
What do you actually want? Because right. I could get this. You. I could get that.
Yeah.
But what do you actually want? You got to go through, okay, I know I could get that. Yeah. I think I could get that. But, dude, that's what I want.
Right.
And I think a lot of us don't even spend enough time thinking about what we want.
And you know what?
I'm pointing at you the whole time.
Yep. And to add to that, what you want, when you get what you want, it evolves to something new.
Absolutely.
It just keeps growing, bro.
Absolutely.
It keeps growing. Yeah. I think people, man, they don't.
No. Mars is living in his world. In a perfect world, it keeps growing, it keeps evolving.
Yeah.
A lot of folks are settled with what they have and they never get to that evolution, boy. It's like my mom retired. So my mom and she's in Cali right now. Oceanside in a little whatever. I'm gonna be real, bro. Like, I went and saw it and was like, yeah, I was in. I leave that alone. But I was like, I let my mom do the process. Let me just put it like that.
Mm-hmm.
I told my mom, I got you.
Yeah.
You know, y'all can stay out there as long as y'all want. And so my mom, she did everything. So I ain't gonna lie, they own the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Their porch is looking at the beach. Mm.
What's like, the problem?
let me just say this, Maul. I feel like when I went to it and I saw it.
I got you. It could be a different experience.
Yeah. I was like, oh, 3-star.
Yep.
Everything you want on the beach, restaurant, everything there.
Yeah.
Okay, let me put it like this. So because I'm taking a group of kids to Dubai,
mm-hmm.
I wanted to see what the other class looked like.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm taking 20 kids. I ain't about to put them, you know, where we were sitting.
Not
you know,
in the shower.
Where you sat, where I sat.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not about to put them there.
Uh-huh.
So the lady said, well, on this plane, there's a premium economy.
Okay.
So I was like, all right, bet. Let me go see it. So we're in a double decker. So I walk downstairs, go check it out. Like, so you walk down the stairs and you can see it right there.
Ghouls and goblins. Don't come down here. He was like,
It was actually nice, Ma.
He was giving his brother's meal down there.
It was actually nice. That's not my swag.
How y'all nice know, of you, racist with your presence.
Yeah, y'all know that's not my swag. So I went down there, I looked, and it was
all dark.
It was
musty.
Actually, they had the lights on.
Did they have a shower down there?
I don't know.
They have a shower. Community shower.
There is a shower.
They just spray you down.
They could just walk straight up, Ma. It's right there. Now, if they let somebody have a little rope that tell them they can't go, that's your business if you let this little rope.
You know
what I'm saying? But I went and...
Oh, shout out to Glenn. Remember that?
Oh, yeah. Glenn. You know what, though? I was going to ask you, see? I'll ask you in a minute. I was going to ask you a question.
Yeah.
I went to go look at it, and you know, Maul, I ain't going to lie.
Premium economy.
It was premium
Name
economy.
Name the podcast, premium economy.
Premium economy. So, Maul, it was like first class.
Yeah.
Mm. It was like first class, a nice first class. You know what I'm saying? It was like economy, but bigger seats.
So what was actual economy like?
I don't know. I didn't go all the way back there. But listen to me. Premium economy wasn't packed at all.
Okay.
There's a bunch of seats. So I was like, yo, we take a 15, 16-year-old, bruh, you can put your thing back and the leg thing come up. I'm like, you good for the trip. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, I don't know about, I just don't know if we're going to be able to, you know what I'm saying, your first trip, you in the, I don't know. But anyway, so I went down there and saw it and was like, okay, cool. All right, makes sense. Came back up and was like, ooh, it's what Maul is saying. We all going to Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
We're not all going in the same experience.
Man.
When I get off this joker, I'm not tired after. Where we flew 14, I wasn't tired. I was like, D, you want to play cards? She's like, no, I'm in my little space. I don't want to talk to you. You know what I'm saying? So the thing died, so we talking a little bit, but she's like, nope, I got movies. I got free. You get free internet the whole way.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? When you sitting up there.
Over the water, bro.
14 hours. 14 hours access, bro.
Wow.
Unbelievable, bro. Technology. I'm talking about 5-star meals.
Yeah.
So
was texting the whole time. I'm like, maybe he just crossed over to New York.
No, the whole time, bro. So to your point, Maul, and to Carl's point, we have to decide not how they want us to travel. I was exposed to, bro, I was sitting in the back of the plane when I first started flying. Why? Because nobody I knew.
Was on that Northwest.
I was Southwest.
Ooh, Southwest.
I'm saying I was on Southwest before I met y'all. Then we was on Northwest.
Oh, that
Northwest
was nice, though.
But we did that Spirit. Remember, we did that Spirit one time in Cali. And
it was me and you that did that.
Okay, it didn't recline.
I didn't know, Maul. The toilet was behind us.
I didn't know, Maul.
What we did in Poland?
Easy way.
Oh, the easy jet.
Easy jet. You can do it easy.
Bro, we was on easy jet.
I was terrible. It was no class.
No class, Maul.
We thought we was in first class, but here go the thing. You board from the back of the plane. So we was really in the,
You
board from the back of the plane.
And go to the front.
And go to
all the front, Maul.
So then you deplane from the back. So we was literally like in the last row.
Last row. Mm. Bro, we got late. But I was just going to say, because I was the first generation to fly, I was in the back. My mother-in-law, I don't know if she ever been to the back.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Because we fly in first class.
Mm.
I fly my kids first class. And it's funny because my son will be like, you know, kind of like, okay, I'll go in the back with the long let boy. And I'm just like, I don't know what you own, but we fly first class.
Yeah.
And it has nothing to do with money. I want to show y'all. Yeah. I need y'all to, you know what I'm saying? I want to show y'all something. Yeah. So you could go wherever. Like, you ain't big time. The plane land, whatever. But I want you to see because if you do it enough, I want you to feel like whatever. Now, Jada do the same thing. Like, dad, she'll fly by herself and she pay for her own ticket. So I was like, don't do that no more. Y'all make sure y'all get their tickets for them, because I don't want you to think you got to go back and forth.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I want you, Maul said exposure. Yep. I want you to feel like whatever, because what I've learned is if you, like Carl said, if it's out there for you to go get, you'll go get it. But if you make a habit of not going to get, you never going to go, like you make it, like you saying, well, I'm going to save because, you know, that's crazy to spend that kind of money. I understand what you're, like, I understand, but you're going to die. What are you saving for? You're going to die. Like, you're not going to be here forever. You're going to die. So what are you holding on to it for? What's the point of, say, like, what are you saving for? Mm-hmm. People say, well, you got kids. My kid's grown. There's two things I'm trying to teach y'all. One, you can do whatever you want to do. And two, go hunt. Like, I need you to know how to hunt. Because if something happens to me, you got to go survive. So I'm not teaching you to live off my money. You know, Jay just got a job with a firm in Chicago. And somebody asked me, how you feel about your son getting a job? I feel great. I feel great. He learned how to hunt. Yep. He learned how to hunt on his own. I don't feel bad as a father. You don't want to continue our legacy. He called me and told me the other day. I thought it was funny. He was like, yeah, I was talking to my man. And he told me in 3 to 5 years, you know, I'll put myself in a situation where I'll be making money for the next generation. And I laughed. I laughed like, me and your mom, you know what I'm saying? But I get what he's saying. That's cool for you.
Yep.
But I don't want to just live off of what you, I want to create my own.
And I say this.
Yeah.
And to your credit, you know, and I think what we all want to do is, and Jalen's how old?
26.
Okay. I'm saying. Most people got to come out of college immediately and try to find a job to just survive. Yeah. It's like because of the discipline and the execution that you had, he was able to go throughout, find out what he wanted to do. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. And he found something that he loves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Through all that he's been through in the last few years, it's like, yo, and he's good at. Like, yo, this is my thing. And he found his thing. And it's like, yo, to your credit, he was able to do that. I want to make sure we give a little bit more practicality before we end the podcast because we've been doing a lot of talking.
Yeah.
Two things. One, I want to take it back to, we talked about Alabama versus Central Michigan. Yeah. Shout out to Central Michigan Grade School, by the way.
Absolutely.
No, no disrespect.
Yeah.
But when TJ was at Central Michigan, there he didn't have a, you know, Julio Jones. Or,
yeah, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
Mark he was Ingram, that.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So talk to the people who like, okay, I hear you. You saying I got to be practicing against Bama, but I play for Central Michigan. Like, I don't, there ain't no, second string is what it is. I can't tackle. Know,
can we say names on here? We okay?
I could care less.
Okay, so let me say this. So I was talking to Sean Hart.
Okay,
every year I do a coaching with Sean.
Shout out to Sean.
So I said to Sean, first and foremost, you got to pay me the 10 grand.
Mm-hmm.
Flat out. And I don't need the money, Sean. Like, I don't need your 10 grand. But if somebody's paying me $180,000 to speak, I can't let you get it for free. Mm-hmm. It's just the law. It's just the law of universe, bro. Like, like, how you going to get it for free? And I'm not suggesting that Sean was trying to get it for free.
Yeah.
But I didn't give him the homie hookup.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, yo, Sean, you the man. You go ahead and pay the big bucks, right? So we do our session. Shout out to Sean. He always do exactly what I say. So at the end, he kind of like, so E, you know, talk to me. Give me the, you gave me the whatever, but give me the whatever. I said, Sean, let me say this to you, bro. I said, here's the only thing that you need to do. You're a beast. But you're not hanging with beasts. Pay to hang with beasts, bro.
There you go.
Just pay the money, bro.
There you go.
Just pay the money, bro.
There you go.
And I got somebody else I want to call because we close to them and they doing their thing. And I'm like, yo, you are in a circle. Like, you ain't growing and you're not growing, not because you can't grow, but you trying to do it without paying. I'm like, yo, Sean, bro, I said, C, love you, bro. You've been through our program. Like, C, respect you as a man. Mm-hmm. Bro, I said, bro, since you met us, because Sean been knowing us forever. Mm-hmm. I'm like, since you met us, Jamal done came on the squad. I said, Tiffany on the squad. Mm-hmm. Moose, Nikki on the squad. Brand, I can just call the names of people out that's beast. I said, Sean, your only problem is you only hanging with good people internally, like your wife, your homie. Like, I said, bruh, just pay to get with beast, bruh. Just pay. That's the only thing. That's the. And I said, everybody can't pay because they're not on a certain level. You're on that level that other beasts would love to have you around. But you just got to pay. And I'm seeing some people who stuck. And I'm like, you're only stuck because you don't want to pay for Alabama. You just got to pay to be on Alabama. That, it is what it is. There are some kids, and you know what I'm talking about, Ma. There are some kids that are good enough, but they didn't get the opportunity. They just got to be walk-ons. Mm-hmm. They're not full scholarship kids, right, but they go walk on just to play. They give up a scholarship, mm-hmm, to not play for that school, to, mm-hmm, play for this school, and they walking on. That any other school, they would be starters, duh, but duh, they're smart enough to know that
the quarterback that just won that championship. What's the quarterback?
What's his name? What's his name?
Who did he play for?
Stetson. He's a walk-on.
He was a walk-on.
For Georgia.
For Georgia. He's a walk-on. So, wow. Same thing. He had scholarships to go all these other places. Wow. So he wanted to go to the best.
So I'm just saying, figure out who you look up to, like where you want to be, what environment you want to be in.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, wake up every single day and pursue that group. So I told y'all, my man Nick came up to me, and I don't know that it's going to work, but he was in Ma's program, right? Mm-hmm. He was in your real estate program. Yep. Just came up with the 10 grand. Like, yep, he go 10, E. I'm like, okay, what you want? He's like, bro, I want to be in the circle.
Yep.
And I was like, oh, okay. I'm just going to keep it 100 with you. I can't guarantee it, but I said, let me let you know something. I'm not about to, if you want to know if I respect what you, like, if you want to know, did I honor what you, of course I did. And I said, I'm going to tell you why. Because everybody coming to me said they want to be and they ain't giving nothing. So the fact that you just walked up and gave me 10 grand, you just said to me, you just separated yourself. Yep. You just gave me 10,000 cash.
Yep.
And said, yo, bro, I want to be down. Okay. Now you still got to go through the process, but trust and believe your name going to come up in the, I sent it to Nikki. Bro, let me tell you something. I sent it to Nikki. Nikki ain't show me no love on the video. I woke up one day, he sent it to me, Ma, and someone. I said, oh, yeah. My man, he ain't. Oh, yeah. I'm like, no doubt about it. Yeah, he sent that joker to me, Ma, and somebody else. Oh, I was like, bro, I love it. Yep. You said, I want to be in this group.
Yep.
This is where I want to be. Sure did. And I'm doing whatever I got to do. I'm talking about it was like a 20-minute jump off of just going at it. Like, I can do this. And so, I'm
who did that?
You wouldn't know him.
He know him, man. No, he know him from Mexico.
He was in Mexico.
My man,
Nick,
that came and met up with that was trying to get us the A5.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. No, I don't, bruh, CJ.
He gave me the 10 grand. He wanted to be a speaker.
No. Here's what he said. Here's what he said. Hey, Ma, he told me, I'll speak for free for the next 3 years. I don't care. You can have all the money. I'll be another CJ. I'll put some more money in your pocket. I just want to be with Beast. Mm. He said, I'm already making money. Mm. I do snow. I make 60 grand when it ain't even snowing. Mm. He said, I don't have no problems making money. I want to be with Beast.
Yep.
I said, bruh, come. I can't. I know what you're saying. I can't. But know that I'm going to try.
Yep.
Know I'm going to pray. I'm going to fast. I'm going to ask God if this is. Yep. But know you're not at the bottom.
Yep.
So here's what okay, C said make it private. Get your doggone name from the bottom of the doggone pile. Mm. Some of y'all, you at the bottom. When I went to go get my PhD, I had to do paperwork, and they was like, bruh, you passed the deadline. Dr. Dunbar was like, don't worry about it. I will go downstairs. He said, I know the person that's pushing the paper. Yep. I'll go downstairs and put your paper. I'm about to put you on the top of the list. Mm-hmm. You understand me? All I know next, clear.
But E, could I say something, bro?
Please.
No, people don't see value in that, though, bro. They don't see value. Remember when we was in, we did a podcast. I think it might have been after the 120 conference. And I talked about being in an uncomfortable, like I pay a trainer to come into my house to make me uncomfortable.
It just don't seem like that I'm supposed to pay. Mall paying.
Bruh.
But that was nothing to do with me. I've been listening to the podcast.
Hey, the trainer. I can understand if I had to pay him to come to his house.
Yes.
He got the weights in his house.
Yeah. Right.
I pay him to come to my house. Yeah. And then this joker started bringing a couple other clients over.
I love it. Why not? Your gym better than my gym.
Don't worry about me.
And then I'm still.
Don't worry about me or Carl.
Yeah.
We good.
I'm still paying Carl.
Yeah. That's when Carl died. Then
and the podcast.
I'm still paying them, right?
Yeah.
And other people paying them too.
Yeah.
In my house.
Yeah. In your house.
Like I should be getting rich, but somebody,
you ain't
somebody,
a cut.
Somebody. Uh-uh. I ain't getting no cut. I'm getting cut. Yeah. I ain't getting that cut.
That's why I don't even put the headphones on, Ma. That's why I don't even put the headphones on,
Ma. But check this out. This is the point though I'm about to get to right now. Some joke on Instagram, because the team cut it up and they make that part like a sponsor ad going around, whatever. Yeah. Bruh, somebody sends me a message. Said, Ma, you surprised me, brother. you must be undisciplined. That's why you need to have somebody come to your house.
Got a point.
Oh, wow. I like where this is headed.
Oh, bro. Oh, you know, I love
oh,
that.
Yeah.
Oh, oh, yeah. My God.
Fuel,
oh,
bro.
Fuel sign your death warrant.
You done got more. Oh, my God.
I'm going to push the button myself.
Oh, right. My God.
So I was like, my man.
Bruh.
My man, you don't pay nobody to come to your house to make you feel uncomfortable because you don't see the value in it.
Yeah.
When you see the value in something, you pay for it.
Yeah.
The only thing you see value in is that value meal at McDonald's that you drive into every single day. Yeah. But it's like, I see value in this. It ain't that I'm the reason why I pay for the man to come to my house is because I'm disciplined.
Yep.
Because I know I'm going to show up every day. Because I know what it's going to do for me, not just for me today, but for me in the long run. You don't see the value in it, or you don't see the value in yourself.
Yeah.
So therefore, you're not willing to spend money to get. I spent, regardless of what y'all think, I spent money to get here.
Yeah.
Not directly, here you go, E, but coming to the conferences.
Oh, no,
here.
Directly.
Directly. Well, not directly.
No, directly.
We ate off of that.
They ate off of it, but I don't even know if you know this.
Yeah.
CJ, probably after the second or third conference seeing me, knowing that I was a police officer, was like, man, Marl ain't got much money. And he came up to me, real talk, told me I didn't have to pay no more. He's like, man, bro, you always come in here, man, bro. You straight.
Wow.
Just throw my name out there, let them know.
He didn't tell me that he's doing that.
That's what I said. Wow. C did this in the beginning, bro. That's before I even connected with y'all.
I forgot
like
that. About
that. C went and told, I don't know if it was LaShana or Tate. He was like, yeah, Marl ain't got to pay good. No more. Man, he good. He come to everything. He showed mad love. Guess what I did?
Paid.
Not only did I pay, I started bringing other people and started paying for them.
Wow.
Just because he came and extended that to me. I saw value, though.
Yeah.
I'm not going to sit here and receive from for free. Yeah. That's got value associated with it.
Yeah.
And I think, man, people need to really, dog, wake up and start understanding, man, when you got value, bro. I didn't just see the value it wasn't even about knowing him or knowing him or knowing y'all. It was about, man, just that whole thing you talk about. Alabama. This was Alabama.
Yeah.
I was practicing against Central Michigan. I wasn't even practicing against Central Michigan. Yeah. I was practicing against Bogan High School. You know what I'm saying? I was practicing against Bogan High School.
Doobie.
Doing the doobie. Way and tear. And it wasn't, and I wasn't, but I felt like, you know what I'm saying? I'm a five-star recruit. Yeah.
I need to be with five-star recruits.
I got to be other five-star recruits. I got to practice against other five-star recruits in order for me to now get to where I got to go.
No doubt.
Hey, thing though, Maul, because you flipped that. I'm sure he's spending money on something that he values.
Oh, no question.
I tell you, I will put, you give me the right trip right now, I'll max every credit card. Yeah. That's my thing. Like, I want to travel with my family. I'll max it out. That's what I value. You see what I'm saying? So I can't never tell you that what you value is something. Why would I approach you with that? I got something that I value. So I'm just saying, like, y'all got to check yourselves. Some of y'all got shoes that you put too much value on. Not you, E.
Yeah, no,
he
no,
paying
no,
for
me.
Him for you. But y'all just making the example. It's some stuff that in each of all of our lives that you value more than you should. That ain't going to do nothing for your life. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So. But yet you don't value
the stuff that really going to make a difference in your life, your kid's life, your family.
I'm telling y'all, just being with Ma, when I went back to Dubai, I hit the sauna every day.
Mm.
I just felt different. Literally, I called my guy in California and was like, Tobe had sent me something. So I went and did some research. Was like, yo, bro, do me a favor. When I get back, I need to have that sauna outside. Ma, I was just like, just hanging with you. I was like, E, why would you be in Dubai enjoying this spa and this hot tub? And the hot tub ain't really my thing. Like, I like the hot tub, but taking a bath can give me that same hookup. Yep. Mm-hmm. The sauna, though, is a different experience.
Different.
Something about being in the sauna all day, that's a little different.
Ooh,
and so by the grace of God,
yesterday.
No question.
Ooh, yesterday.
No question. Yeah. No question, see?
Now, I ordered about 6 months ago.
It's okay.
I put together yesterday.
Yeah, no question.
Ooh. Right?
No, see, it don't
see
make...
It,
the dry heat, boy?
Yeah.
It infrared. Don't,
bro, you got to put that video up. That's fine.
No, don't put the video up.
Okay.
Right.
I'm just saying, though.
He got to expose the people, man.
No, I'm just saying to you.
Now, meanwhile, he got me putting my whole house up on the internet.
Yeah, right.
I'm talking about my bedroom.
Yeah, that's... Hey. It's all for the, you know, he got a plan, bro. We
what
got
was
a
you about
plan.
To ask me? You said you had a question. You forgot.
No, that was earlier about Australia.
Yeah.
When we was in the 10,000 boys, you used to say it was something up, you used to say used to talk about it was another something up there. Was it really? It was?
Are you talking about another class?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was only like two seats.
It was only two seats?
Yeah, it was only two seats up there.
Wow.
Remember, I asked the flight attendant, I was like, hold on.
And how different did they look than ours?
Quite a bit.
Oh, it did? Okay. Yeah. Well, I never went.
It was Qantas.
Yeah, you just told me ES2.
Yeah, she was like, no, it's only like two up there. Mm. And I just looked in there. But okay. No, it was probably like, not on Emirates level, but it was nice. Enough.
Yeah.
It was nicer than what we had.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And that was our first time.
Oh,
whatever.
Yeah. We were.
Doing but it. I'm just saying, to my point with exposure.
Oh, we was doing it.
Guys.
Oh, they had the, the
chicken schnitzel.
Chicken schnitzel.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, that chicken schnitzel was fine.
Oh, schnitzel.
Yeah, chicken schnitzel. It's okay. It's for the podcast.
No, I had one.
Yeah, no question. It's for the podcast. You know your role.
Listen, shout out to Organifi, man, the superfood green juice powder, keeping this podcast sponsored
and
up.
And CJ.
Man, we love you. And shout out to Game Changers, all right? Man, we just certified a whole new class. Shout out to all my certified Game Changers. Man, we Mike Shelton, shout out to you, and shout out to everybody who came through the program and got certified, man. It was an amazing training over the weekend. We talked about what type of speaker are you, and most people look at, you know, the E's and the Inkies and, you know, that of the world, and they think, I either got to be a motivational speaker or nothing at all. Well, listen, in Game Changers, we identify what type of speaker you are, right, and show you how you don't have to be a motivational speaker to get paid 6-7 figures in this industry. And that's what we've been doing. Listen to this testimonial from my man Lester. He said, I was once in prison for 22 years. Game Changers helped me become laser focused on my messaging, which resulted in my first $50,000 contract in the same prison I was once housed in.
Wow. Let's go.
Did you hear what I said?
Same prison I was once housed
in. This man was in jail in South Carolina for 22 years. Came out and got a $50,000 contract to go back. And train them. All right, so we're going to teach you how to become a professional speaker, how to get paid at the highest level. Go to freespeakertest.com. Freespeakertest.com. We're going to give you a test to find out what type of speaker you are, what type of speaker you should be in the industry, because you don't have to be ET. You don't have to be, you know, pumping people up. You have an area of expertise that you want to train in and get paid for. Go to freespeakertest.com, take that test, and we'll be with you. Find out how we can help you get to that next level. Maul, what's going on with Make Real Estate Real?
Man, people are closing deals.
Right, shout out to Jamel. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
The young boy. Oh, bro. Closed 100,000. 21. How is he? 24?
He's somewhere right
there. And was on vacation shortly after.
Oh, bro, he went out the country.
Living on the left side.
Costa Rica.
He kept sending me videos like every single day, like, Maul, left side. He said, I finally know what the left side means, Maul. I finally know. Yeah, man. Now, people closing deals, man. You know what? It ain't even about closing deals no more. It's about people are finally realizing their dreams.
Mm.
One property at a time. I tell people, dog, you one property away. You are literally... No, whatever it is in your life, that dream, whatever it is you want to do, you got the barrier is that one property.
That one property.
You're one property away from getting to that dream, whatever that dream is.
Mm. Yeah, absolutely. Carl, what's going on with Deeper Than the Brand?
Oh, man. I
see y'all keep meeting in the metaverse.
Yes, sir.
By the way, I'll talk about it next week. Bruh, them Oculus.
The Oculus?
Have you done it?
No.
Different experience,
bro. I thought it was cap.
You got it?
No, no, different no, no. Listen, experience.
I
bro.
Thought it was cap. Bro,
we training in there.
No, no,
already.
No. I thought. Bring them up here. You have to bring them up here.
I'll bring them on.
Yeah, bro. I thought it was cap. Fam, it is unbelievable, bro. Like, no, I'm not even kidding. I'm like, you ain't got to go to Dubai.
No, legitimately.
You buy you a pair of these. They ain't paying, bro.
No, no.
Listen to what I'm telling you.
No question.
You put them joints, bro. I was like.
I didn't know what you're talking about.
Yo, I was like, yo, everywhere. This will mess you up.
Everywhere.
It'll mess you up, bro.
Everywhere. No, no, seriously. Week. So, again, to C's point, like, man, we're not playing around. We understand that things are changing fast, and we're trying to stay with it. So we actually launched something called MetaSuite. Now, y'all can't get into it yet. But the reality is we are literally training in the metaverse. Like, I'm going to put the secret out. Every single member, we paid for the headsets and sent it to you. You bought in, we're going to support you. Mm-hmm. And we're in there training. Last week we had a session. See, we broke down everybody's brand. We're looking at your whole social media profile, going through it, doing a SWOT analysis with it.
Bro, you in the world. Bro, like, bro, it's weird.
I can't do it no more.
I took them joints off. Like, this messing me up.
No, I got motion sickness. I've been playing one day, and let me hit this roller coaster. Bro, I took them off. No, I was motion sick legitimately. Nah, it's as real as
real
could be.
I did the rock climbing one, the free solo rock climb. Bro, you'd be like, I'm talking, bro. It's. I yeah, thought it was real. Just like a little TV screen or something. You know, I don't know what I thought.
Hey, they got a workout one?
Yes.
You got boxing? Oh, yeah. You can fight?
The workout one is really the one that started
really
it all.
You really scrap somebody.
Yeah. That's the one that
I'm started
it all.
I'm talking about dude running up on you, feel like you really got to fight.
Yeah. No,
bro, it's crazy.
I don't want to get techie, but okay, the headset makes sense. You'll understand. But why do you hear it like that?
Oh, it makes no sense.
Especially audio, too.
There's no headphones on it.
Yeah. Your ears are exposed, but you're hearing the world you're in.
In your brain, though.
Bruh, it is unreal.
I'm like, is the sound coming through my eyes?
It's unreal. But yeah, anyway.
That makes sense.
I2C, man, we just launched I2C, like, for real. All the programs, all the training, all the courses
catch up, in I2C. Catch up.
You join that, and we got the whole path laid out for you. Take your idea of creation. Path. The whole path.
Hey, real quick before we get out of here. I saw something and I was like, man, now he is our sandwich connoisseur.
Yeah. Facts.
I saw something last night, me and my pops sitting there watching the game. Have y'all heard of this Land, Air, and Sea? Mm-mm. No. So McDonald's got a sandwich called Land, Air, and Sea.
Wow.
I got a picture of it, I believe.
Land, Air,
it's all three,
and Sea.
All three meats. All three meats
put together.
No question.
Dang.
No question.
It's a Big Mac, chicken sandwich, and fish sandwich all together.
No doubt.
Wow.
No doubt. I don't eat McDonald's, and I'm going to get one.
Bruh.
Yeah, I don't eat McDonald's.
I want to know from listener land. Maybe Isaiah, you could put up a poll.
It looks funny. It looked like it'll play with you. I'm not gonna say.
Hey, Carl, if we could get this on the screen, I said, hold on, McDonald's. Y'all didn't. When people were suing McDonald's for getting fat, I was against that because I'm like, yo, you ain't got to go.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying? But I think they might got a case now.
Oh, they
you
got a case, bro.
Land,
all
Air,
three.
Brother,
I'm
going
to wait for Dubai to do it though, because I know they're gonna do the mixture
gonna do
right.
All three.
Yeah.
Right,
brother. Land, Air, and Sea.
Unbelievable.
Land,
listen to me.
Air and Sea.
Listen, see before.
But first of all, then the other thing I said: do chickens fly? Because that's
technically
not air.
Technically not.
Yeah, that ain't air.
But you get
but
it,
they
though.
Jump
a little
bit.
Yeah, but you, they got wings.
Birds.
So you're right.
They got wings.
You get the concept. But here's what I'm saying, though. Yo, for real, you only live once. You plan it safe.
You got to eat a land there.
No, I'm just saying. You only live once. You plan it safe. And you missing out on all everybody growing and developing, bro.
Man.
Everybody
with
evolving.
With that
everybody.
Being said. You know what I'm
saying? Everybody evolving,
Mickey bro. D's like, we got, bro. Bro, I saw that. I thought it was a joke.
Maul,
it's out right now.
Maul, I ain't had a computer since 2015. Facts. I haven't bought a computer since 2015, bro. Everybody evolving, bro.
Hey, next podcast, we're going to get one. We're going to let Maul try it live on the pod.
Let's
Maul's
go.
Maul's going to take a bite of it live on the
let's
pod
go.
And report to the people. That's our duty.
Yeah, come on.
We inform
the people. You're the only one that can afford to
work
out.
Why you say Maul?
You're working out.
I won't see
you look fire.
Bump that, Maul.
No, you the most in shape. One of us eat it, we're going to turn
it
into a gumball.
I'll eat it for you.
Let's go.
I don't care nothing about
it. No, y'all can split it. Okay?
We're doing this now.
Stay tuned.
I got
next
you.
Week, maybe next week, week after, one of these
hey,
weeks.
Hey, and I say
we're
this,
we're going to try Land, Air, and Sea.
Maul can continue. Like, this is not to discourage anybody. But when they put me in the box, I'm going to be as fit as everybody else. So bring that joker to
me,
Maul.
Let me tell you something. You're going to be super fit. In the metaverse, you can be what you
want
to be.
You can be what you want.
You can become your own avatar.
Yeah, literally.
So you could just be, you know, six-packed out, eating Land, Air, and Sea. Yeah. All right, we out of here. We love you. We'll see you next week.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your